Okay, so my opponent doesn't have a mic, so it's gonna be quite one-sided, the commentary, but yeah, well, that's life.
Hello and welcome to this magnificent stadium, which is hosting this fascinating encounter. Brutality, underhand tricks, and plenty of hemoglobin are on the program. And I'm happy to be sharing the spectacle with Bob Bifford, our expert summarizer.
Greetings to all of you out there.
We're in for an evenly matched game.
Yup. It's a brave man who tries to predict the final score.
Oh, no. We have a blizzard moving in.
Yeah, looks like it, Jim. Teams will have to watch that ice on the pitch.
Not only that, Bob, it looks like they can't throw the ball too far either.
And of course we had snow. That's no good. Well, it might play to my favor since he's a passing team, and that's gonna be a bit of a problem for him.
Every now and again, Blood Bowl throws up a real mixed bag of a team.
Like the Motley Horde, that's made up of a bunch of misfits.
Yeah, can't be easy to coach those cast-offs every day of the week.
Here we go again for another bloodbath.
If he wants to play Bashy, Bashy it is.
A recent medical report stated that cerebral hemorrhages were less frequent in Blood Bowl players. Amazing, when you come to thinking.
Not really, when you consider that brains are also less frequent.
Well, no surprise there that he's gonna get away with dodging. And he's building a cage. Huh, that's kind of quite interesting for an elf team. Thank you.
that's one with a good reason to go see the apothecary.
Yep, looks like he's gonna need a good one.
Did you know that dwarf runners are trained in the same way as city watchdogs?
No.
Yeah. The coach hides a pint of beer somewhere inside a warehouse, and all the players on the team are then sent to find it. The first one to the beer is named Runner.
This pair was really strong. Do you think they have some troll blood in them?
Could be. Or maybe his opponent shouldn't speak that way about the family.
Poetry in motion.
What we'd like to see
more often.
So let's try and push him back towards the goal line.
There was a time when the Colleges of Magic hadn't yet ruled on limiting wizard assistance to teams.
Who could forget the infamous 2472 Quagmire incident, when rampant spellcasting caused the entire Bright Crusaders Stadium to sink into the earth?
Nobody could forget that. People were blinded for miles around the stadium.
I can live with that result.
Wizards have not always been able to cast spells safely from behind the sidelines. Were you playing at the time in an Albion League, a second division that prohibited spellcasting from off the pitch?
Oh, yes. They were great times. I remember fans traveling to games just to see how well Wizards stood up to the mad charge of a raving Blood Bowl star. The noise created by a sizzling fireball, followed by the characteristic sound of the snapping of a wizard's neck.
Like there was some bad blood between those two, eh, Bob?
Yeah, Jim. Something to do with swapped body parts. Ouch! Have a nice sleep.
Little baby gets his medicine and he's having a little nap.
That player's taken away on a stretcher.
But still alive, I can see the drool.
Thank you.
Now, the Dwarfs have an excellent approach to a match. As they always say, seek out fear to overcome it. Fatigue to go beyond it. Adversity to conquer it.
And the ball if you've got nothing better to do.
I just have to make sure it doesn't get past my line. Because there's no way in hell that I'm gonna be able to catch him then.
You can't say much about that.
Full-blooded, but perfectly legal.
Well, I still got a couple of tackle zones to get through, so...
The Blood Bowl...
Or not.
...stories of teams who've gone bust with crippling debts.
And with the cost of doping and bribery on the rise, the problem won't be going away.
Hair products, check. Scantily clad players, check. If I didn't know better, I could have mistaken these for an Amazon team, Bob.
Don't be silly, Jim. I don't think I know anyone that fears an elf.
That's true, Bob.
Well, it's gonna need two turns at least to get, so that's something.
Thank you.
The Troll Slayers. You know that their first appearance dates back to 2465 in a match between the Giants and Lowdown Rats.
No, I didn't. You know, me and the dwarves, I...
A blitzer called Stout Iron Fist was given the task of protecting the king's son. However, the rats managed to blind Stout, and by the time he was able to clear his eyes, the king's son had been killed by the rat's troll. Stout, of course, flew into a frenzy and decapitated the troll.
Ouch, poor troll. Nice left punch, right on the nose.
Sure was, Jim. It's broken now.
Oh, a kill. Sweet, sweet.
Finished him.
Well, no doubt his cardiopulmonary system wasn't up to Blood Bowl level.
If insults had any effect on the trajectory of the ball, I guarantee that the dwarfs would be world champions. Oh, brilliant side kick to the face. Let's see that again in slow motion.
Okay, let's see if he gets out of this. It is fairly open for him, so he should be able to. I guess I should thank him for
today's
that move.
Today's invite comes from Jaime Schnibbel, coach and owner of the Goblin.
That way you feel like a butter from me.
In yesterday's Spike magazine, he said that Blood Bowl was like war. No winners, just survivors.
Oh, that's deep. About as deep as his team's position in the rankings. I think she's singing him a lullaby. Just look at the way his
oops
eyes are twitching.
The punch is still echoing round his body.
Somehow he managed to slip the tackle.
What a shame.
Ooh. Am I gonna be able to reach him? It's a tough one.
Go
open is really endemic in this sport.
Isn't it? Two extra rolls? No. Especially not in this weather. So, I guess we're just gonna make it hurt for him.
I bet that hurt. Good job his nose got in the way.
Yeah, otherwise he'd have got it full in the face. Think he'll be able to get up after that blow, Jim?
Oh, yes. He's not the sort to stay down.
Corruption so widespread that the Referees Guild has set up rules concerning where, when, and how one can accept a bribe.
Under an agreement signed last season, the clubs are not allowed to offer less than the going rate. Ouch! That punch knocked his teeth down his throat!
Yes, Jim. That's never a nice sight. Go!
Yeah, that was an expected touchdown.
Did you hear about the evil Gits? The team that is made up of a mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen. That's it. The ball's in play. There's gonna be trouble.
Okay, let's start by doing some damage. And I think my lucky dice from the last match is with me.
Are selling big moot sandwiches in the stands.
Hey, I'm off to get one. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
And so now you like big moot sandwiches?
Yes, no way. A little elf? Yeah.
What? Right on the schmuzzle.
He'll have a bit of trouble blowing his nose from now on. He didn't react fast enough there.
No. To be effective, you've got to get your retaliation in first.
What violence?
Yes, it's a great spectacle, Bob. Now there's one that won't be coming back in a hurry.
I doubt he'll be taking any further part in the match after that.
No, he's still got two legs.
He's knocked them senseless.
You're assuming then that he had something between his ears to begin with.
Okay, let's see if we can actually pick this up.
If I can get their game going.
Woohoo! I got it. Well, he doesn't have that many players left in the field, so that's in my favor.
Pinch and handbag the culprit. She had a total of 120 KOs during his career. Shame she disappeared during a match against the Lowdown Rats when she tried to spike the troll.
May she rest in peace.
I can live with that. That too.
The Troll Slayers. You know that their first appearance dates back to 2465 in a match between the Giants and Lowdown Rats.
No, I didn't. You know, me and the Dwarves, I...
A blitzer called Stout Iron Fist was given the task of protecting the King's son. However, the Rats managed to blind Stout, and by the time he was able to clear his eyes, the King's son had been killed by the Rats' troll. Stout, of course, flew into a frenzy and decapitated the troll.
Ouch. Poor troll. He checked that move.
Made him look stupid, you mean?
Yeah, I feel pretty safe in that position. One has got the two up, well, now three up. That's okay. Five players on the pitch, yeah, I can live with that.
You know, the luckiest elf team out there must be Celestial Comets, Bob.
How's that, Jim?
Because College of Celestial Magic is sponsoring them.
That might explain why their passes are always on target, Jim.
I don't know if he really liked that uppercut.
He may not have liked it, but he certainly ate it. We can expect to see some high-quality throwing plays today, Jim.
Indeed we can, Bob. Hopefully some carnage as well.
Yes, Jim. It's all about the carnage. A good elf is a dead elf.
Maybe I shouldn't have taken that runner all the way up there. Maybe I should have just stayed one step behind, but yeah. Should have quite a lot of tactics on to run through, so I should be good.
Just look at the fans. They're red hot. A majority of supporters reckon that the league should take measures to prevent the small minority of peaceful fans from watching a match from the terraces.
They've got a point. If they don't want to join in the fun, they might as well stay home and watch it on cablevision.
Oh, he's actually gonna make it. Oh, I can live with that result. Well, that works too.
boom in the face, and then followed by a clean uppercut. Well done.
I wonder if they will actually fight today, or just avoid confrontation altogether as usual, Bob.
As always, Jim, I don't think these elves are any different from the others.
Well, apart from their scantily outfits and weird hairdos, they seem to play the same boring throwing game as their cousins. He sent him down for a chat with the Astro Granite.
I'll just do a side maneuver. Oh yeah, crap, it's the last round. Oh well, whatever. I get the ball anyway.
Ooh, take a look at how they prance, Bob.
That's called sidestepping, Jim, which the elves are masters at.
Still looks like prancing to me, Bob.
Sure does, Jim.
Oh, it's getting warm back here. Second half is gonna get brutal. I have 8 turns now to actually get to over the line. And I'm happy with my lineup.
Don't hit me, don't hit me.
I'm sorry, that's an old reflex on hearing the starting whistle. I've heard of teams that have simply disappeared after being abandoned by their supporters.
Let's say that some teams who haven't won a match for several years have been tied up by their fans and thrown into rubbish containers.
It's the only way to end a downward spiral.
It seems this player does all the talking with the fist.
And they clearly know how to get heard.
Less on the field.
What finish! What style! What perfection!
What a hammer blow!
This player has opened
the and another one off the field. This is going great.
What a sissy! That one can't hold the ground. Right in the face. The other guy couldn't dodge that one.
wonder if they will actually fight today or just avoid confrontation altogether as usual, Bob.
Let's see if I can pick it up. Oh no. I failed my sure hands.
Outfits and weird hairdos, they seem to play the same boring throwing game as their cousins.
Ooh, let's see some bits from bits action. Ah, crap. Knocked him down.
Finally, there's one that lets his biceps do the talking.
Yeah, but from his opponent's point of view, it was a short conversation.
The referee's guild has decided to hire a bodyguard for each game.
Another brilliant idea. And just how effective will one bodyguard be against a stadium full of supporters?
True. Could be a bit one-sided.
Not as I had planned, but... I still get to play at least, so...
They can start to move forward. We don't see much of the heroes of law these days.
I don't know.
For any spectators who aren't aware, the heroes of law hope to show the world a better way by honest, strategic play on the pitch.
That's probably a good
thing. Okay, let's see how this will work out. Six stars to go. And half a pitch. The question is, should I push for the 2-1 or I just go for a tie and let's see what happens then. He could get two people back up if I'm unlucky.
Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say. But it really only comes down to taking a few hits. That's what happens when a pro crosses an amateur.
Yes, splodge. Did you hear about the evil
game? Yeah, that works.
The team that is made up of the mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen.
This cannon bad. I can leave one. That's not too bad. Oh yeah, he rolled a 6, so he needs 9 plus.
Just look at the fans. They're red hot. A majority of supporters reckon that the league should take measures to prevent the small minority of peaceful fans from watching a match from the terraces.
They've got a point. If they don't want to join in the fun, they might as well stay home and watch it on cablevision.
Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say, but it really only comes down to taking a few hits.
Let's see if he's willing to gamble with this blitzer or if he's going to do something else. Yeah, it would be a 2-die block where I shoot, I believe. Maybe even a 3-die block. No. Z3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, maybe. Nothing. Oh, he's... that move. Yeah, that can work. That means he's taking out a couple of tackles. Yeah, there he got an assist without the tackle zone. So he actually get to the rock. Well played, I gotta say. I don't see how that... Oh, well, he got out of the 2 tackles, so that may just make a difference.
To me, Bob.
Sure does, Jim.
As soon as he throws his first punch,
we know the opponent will be out for lunch. We can expect to see some high-quality throwing plays today, Jim.
Indeed we can, Bob. Hopefully some carnage as well.
Yes, Jim. It's all about the carnage. A good elf is a dead elf.
Three left on the field. That's nice numbers. I like those. Oh yeah, everyone except for the dead guy is KO. That doesn't even give points. Bugger. Thank you.
Look over there. Some cute little elf beauties are selling Big Moot sandwiches in the stands.
Hey, I'm off to get one. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
And so now you like Big Moot sandwiches?
Yes, no way. A little elf beauty, yeah.
One regulation clobbering.
Well, that'll keep him quiet for a while.
Yeah, he's just stuck. Not dead. The pitch is no place to lie down for a sleep.
And that didn't work out too bad.
He doesn't have any choice.
Let's score them.
Well, the dwarves have an excellent approach to a match. As they always say, seek out fear to overcome it. Fatigue to go beyond. Adversity to conquer.
And the ball has got nothing better to do.
And he gets two back in. So we got five. Well, I can live with that. Should be easy enough to handle. Well, this is quite a quick match. That's nice. Ooh, making a nice tower.
The players are positioned and we're off.
Oh, pitch invasion. Ouch, that hurts.
Yeah, the luckiest elf team out there must be Celestial Comets, Bob.
How's that, Jim?
Because College of Celestial Magic is sponsoring them.
That might explain why their passes are always on target, Jim.
Decisions, decisions, decisions. Wonder what he's gonna do.
I've heard of teams that have simply disappeared after being abandoned by their supporters.
Let's say that some teams who haven't won a match for several years have been tied up by...
No way I'm going to be able to beat that one up. Well, I guess I could get rid of both of them. Thanks to him moving there instead of the square above. If he had moved there or there, then I wouldn't have been able to. Oh, he got it. That only means he's in a reducer target. Although I won't be able to make it.
They've been pushed off the side.
I hope they have good life insurance.
Oh crap, the wrong runner.
There was a time when the Colleges of Magic hadn't yet ruled on limiting wizard assistance to teams.
Who could forget the infamous 2472 Quagmire incident, when rampant spellcasting caused the entire Bright Crusaders Stadium to sink into the earth?
Nobody could forget that. People were blinded for miles around the stadium.
One that won't be coming back in a hurry. Opponent down.
This is good sport.
The most famous blocker was probably Pendy No Luck Stonewall. Remember him, Bob?
Oh, yeah. Every time he took a hit, his old mother used to come on the pitch and handbag the culprit. She had a total of 120 KOs during his career. Shame she disappeared during a match against the Lowdown Rats when she tried to spank the troll.
May she rest in peace. What style, what perfection.
What a hammer blow. Upside down, that's one way to look at things. Oh, no, another one who actually plays the ball. If insults had any effect on the trajectory of the ball, I guarantee that the Dwarfs would be world champions.
Okay, that should work. That should give us a tie, and I believe we're going into overtime after that.
Well, another draw. What do you have to say, Bob?
A useless game.
Ah, no, in the match. So, 1-1. And, well, it was a good game.